Promotional, another consideration provided by NVIDIA.
Hi, my name is Mike Thompson. I am an illustrator and a digital sculptor. Over the past 25 years, I've worked with clients such as Marvel, Nike, Warner Brothers, Hasbro, and Dimension Films. So I've been using the HP ZBook Create for a few weeks now, and it has a lot of things that have me very excited. The form factor of the machine, first of all, is amazing. It's very small, very light. It has some very attractive lines on it. Aside from the aesthetics, the interior is what got me really excited. It's got the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2080 Super with Max-Q design. I have a 2080 Ti on my desktop, and the performance is very similar. The 4K Dream Color display, it's very color accurate, very bright. The colors are very saturated, and I like that a lot. And with 32 gigabytes of RAM on an i9, it's a very fast machine and handles a lot of what I needed to do as far as performance is concerned. The first thing I'll do is open up the acceleration engine when I start Painter and run it. Make sure I have my other applications closed just so I can get kind of a true number. And what that does is start to lay down strokes on the page, and it looks at how fast your machine is running, looks at the specs of it, and then when it's done, it gives you a benchmark number. Corel has found a way to take advantage of the NVIDIA graphics card and DirectX 12 to make my brushes much faster. They've doubled the number of GPU accelerated brush engines from Painter 2020. So there's a huge number now that I can select from. By typing multi-core into the search engine, it pulls up the brushes that take advantage of multiple cores on the machine. I can select one of them and draw out my strokes, and there's no lag. It doesn't matter how large I make the stroke. One of the brushes that I really like now is the oily bristle brush, and that looks a lot like what I used to work with when I was painting traditionally. It's one of my favorites to block in background colors. I can type in AVX2, and that pulls up brushes as well that are optimized to work with your machine and are very quick and snappy. And finally, I can type in GPU, and that pulls up even more brushes that are optimized to really fly on whatever your machine specs are. So these are all the graphic intensive brushes that in the past would have given my computer a little bit of a challenge and made it lag a little bit. Completely lag free now. Very smooth. I can lay down strokes and I don't have to wait for anything. It's instant on the screen. I can make the brushes really large, whereas in the past that would slow down the performance, and it just doesn't do it anymore. For an artist who has to live and die by deadlines, it's really fantastic. For my demo today, I'll be working on an alien that I created for a class that I'm teaching. And I thought it would be interesting to do something that's a little outside of my wheelhouse. I don't normally do a lot of sci-fi stuff, but I wanted to do something that felt a little fun and take advantage of the fact that I could work on a machine that is futuristic, so I'm doing something sci-fi. So my normal workflow when I'm doing illustrations for package design for, say, like Hasbro or Mattel, is I usually start in ZBrush. I will take a character, either a provided OBJ of the toy or a sculpt that I've made myself, and start to pose that and light it really roughly. I might do some poly painting on it to get the colors. And then I'll take that straight into Corel Painter and start to do my paint over of it. So I figured for this project, I'd do the same type of workflow for my alien character. And you can see that I started with some Z-spheres in here and started to sculpt in the details for the legs, the arms, helmet, all that kind of stuff. Even though ZBrush doesn't take advantage of the GPU, it does use the CPU, and the HP ZBook Create that I'm using has an i9, which is more than capable of handling anything I can throw at it from ZBrush. So once I have my character looking the way that I want in ZBrush, I will do a quick poly paint on him and then throw him over into Photoshop to composite the layers, and then take it back into Painter to start my paint. One thing that I noticed about using Painter 2021 with the HP ZBook Create that I'm on right now is that the NVIDIA GPU accelerated brushes in Painter really move fast. Most of the brushes that I've collected and am really comfortable using are all accelerated. They either take advantage of the GPU, the multi-core, or the AVX2 optimization that Corel Painter 2021 has with NVIDIA. I always loved Corel's brushes just because they always felt very real to me, and they work very similarly to the way that I paint outside of the computer. Now they're all up to 15 times faster with this RTX Studio GPU. It's a win-win. You took something that I already liked and you made it even better. So what you'll see here is as I'm grabbing some of my chalk brushes and going in and adding to the detail that's already in the sculpt, just kind of punching that up. When I'm done with this piece, my main goal is that I don't want you to really be able to see that I sculpted it first. I want it to just feel like one of the illustrations that I had done in the past. So just going in and punching up the edge lighting. I like for all of my illustrations to really have like a nice strong edge light. And I think that comes from my comic book roots. I used to love reading comics when I was a kid, and I always loved the way that the characters always look larger than life. And I think a lot of that came from dramatic lighting and dramatic pose. So I try to incorporate that into all of my illustration now. This project was really fun. I got to go between working on this on the HP ZBook and then doing my regular work on my desktop. And what I normally find when I'm going between a laptop and my desktop is that the laptop experience isn't usually as seamless or even fun. I'm very aware of how loud my fans normally are spinning on my normal laptop and how hot it becomes, or the screen is never as nice as my display in the studio. But I didn't have any of those issues on this. And in fact, other than the form factor, the experience was virtually the same. I've never been able to say that about a laptop before. So I got to concentrate on the art, which is the best thing an artist can do. You know, I didn't have to worry about the experience other than just getting it out of my head and onto the canvas for creating any illustration, whether it be poster or toy design or toy packaging, anything like that. I always go to Painter first. That's what I've been using for the past, I don't know, 15 years or so. And that's never going to change. What has changed is that the brushes are all much faster now. It's smoother, and it's the closest I've come to painting by hand. Once I'm done in Painter, I hop into Photoshop and do some last-minute effects tweaks. Just kind of making the liquid at the top of his helmet and then dialing in some color correction, things like that. I know that you can do this in Corel Painter as well. I kind of learned this in Photoshop, and I really enjoy the fact that I can hop between applications. I use a lot of different applications, and the fact that it's so seamless really makes my job a lot easier. I hope you all enjoyed this video and found it helpful. And if you want to see more, please subscribe to my YouTube.